bountiful, sweaty, corrupt place, you know. Lot of gangsterism, children getting indoctrinated by the wrong people and throwing their lives away for nothing. Yeah. It's a very dangerous area, this. We don't have, like, a proper infrastructure. People are forced to go into these lives because most of them, they don't come out of a good household. Mother and father are druggies, alcoholics, and they don't get love there, so they resort to joining a gang where they do get some sort of love. And they can feel, they feel like they connect to these people who they were with. And then they, yeah, they go into a deeper, deeper hole. Well, in this year alone, I've seen a lot of people, a lot of children in my road drop out of school. It starts with one friend, then the other friend wants to do it, and the other friend, and it starts a chain reaction within it, yeah. I like surrounding myself with positive people, people that I can learn things from, not people that can bring me down or teach me the wrong things, you know?
I started smoking weed. Most of my friends dropped out. I felt like I'm the only one still around. Nothing was motivating me. I was the only one feeling hopeless, like vulnerable to the outside world, and so I started leaving. And I was also grade 11 that time, standard 9. And yeah, I dropped out, and here I am. At times, I regretted, but it was my decision. I can't change time, can't go back in time. It's been like 3-4 years from like now, so.
I would say that the main reason I dropped out, I was going through a lack of purpose, lack of, I was just bored with the classroom and not really feeling it. I was depressed most of the time. I didn't have really much friends, and so school just became like an endless round of being told what to do by the teachers and being commanded and just treated as a lesser being, not treated as an equal, so to say. There are times when I regret dropping out, but I feel like I needed to do that because now there's no other way for me to make it unless I push my hardest. It's like I either do this or it's nothing.
My downfall was I started selling drugs at school because I saw my friends doing it and I thought, what the hell, let me also do it. And that's how I got expelled from the school. My mom enrolled me at Bontivalai, school just here around the corner by us. There's always trouble, people stabbing each other, children swearing, fighting with the teachers especially. And I dropped out again when I got there because I saw this is not a learning environment for me. I regret it every day of my life because every day I wake up, it's the same thing. Rap, smoke, play soccer, repeat. The highest grade I finished was grade 9, and you can't get many opportunities with that. Maybe sweeping the streets, maybe, if I'm lucky. That's what I see myself doing. Maybe working myself up from that, starting low, and climbing up. Opportunity for me is something that can get you to where you want to be one day. There's an opening, and here are you. So it's up to you whether or not you take that opportunity to get you where you want to be. This is not where I want to be all of my life. I want to make it out. I want to be successful, make it big.
Most of the time I think like we'll be stuck there forever. Like society will draw us in on the things that they're doing, the wild, the dangers of the world, like gangsterism and things like that. We'll be part of it or we'll just be the ones to just get away. But that's the question we all ask ourselves, what are we going to be 10 years from now, 5 years from now?
What do you mean by home is a trap?
Well, everything is the same here.
We're all stuck in the trap, that's what we call the trap. We should call the community actually.
Because if you're going to live here forever, then that means you've been caught up in the trap. And it's got the best of you, you didn't persevere. You didn't strive to get out of it. You just became part of the system, you know? And there's so much mirrors around us that we should be aware of what's going to happen in the future, you know? So we try to prevent it by any means necessary.
For us to live in this environment means we're always going to be exposed to those things. No matter where we look, no matter where we turn to, there's going to be these negative things that's trying to pull us in. And that is the trap, because if we just give up and we sit and let these negative forces take a hold of us, and then one day we'll find ourselves in the same position. So the only thing we can do is fight and strive for something better.
Tristan, what's your name? P-W-L-O, P-L-O.
Aiden Davis, also known as The View.
Lance Gilliver-Nislin, also known as L, Lieutenant of the Trap. Shock Music. Thank you.